XFM News. On point.
Thank you for joining us. Let's take a look at the news. President Yoweri Museveni has assured Ugandans that the forthcoming general elections will be peaceful without being interrupted by people of ill motive. Museveni, who was speaking during the national Thanksgiving prayers held at State House in Entebbe, said the NRM government fought in order for peaceful elections to take place, and so he will not tolerate any person that may want to cause violence during the elections.
Games which have been played here by the foreigners, by the Wazungu, by some other people. I wish them good luck, but I can assure you we shall have peaceful elections. And anybody who puts himself on the path of wanting to disturb our right, you have no right to disturb my peace, to throw stones at me, to stop me from speaking. Let everybody follow the law, then there will be peace.
Museveni has also warned the public against complacence in dealing with COVID-19, which has resulted into a spike in numbers.
So people have died. They have died unnecessarily because people, I don't know what to say. So therefore, from the beginning, we told you, don't send Berera. And this, for you the Christians, it is in the Bible here, in the book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 12. And this was not such a serious disease, this was a leprosy.
The Electoral Commission has summoned presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu and FDC presidential candidate Patrick Oboi Amuriat to explain their continued flouting of electoral guidelines. According to the letter signed by the chairman of the commission, Simon Mujenye Byabakama, Kyagulanyi and Amuriat have continuously held mass rallies of more than 200 people, which increases the risk of spreading COVID-19 among the community, yet the pandemic is at a critical stage 4 of spread. Byabakama, as Kyagulanyi must appear at the commission on Monday, 14th December, 10 a.m., and Amuriat at 11 a.m. to explain their side of the story and forge a way forward and how to control the crowds. Byabakama has also summoned Chotera County MP Haruna Cheyune Kasolo, Ndiganga Municipality MP Peter Mugema to appear before the commission Monday, 11:30 a.m. regarding their continued flouting of electoral guidelines. Cabinet has directed Kampala Capital City Authority to build new public toilets and other sanitation facilities in the city. The Minister for Kampala, Betty Amongi, said the project is aimed at effecting proper hygiene within the city centre. She said the authority has planned to construct over 40 public toilets in divisions, and users will be required to pay 200 Uganda shillings.
We are going to put them in areas like taxi parks, markets, on our areas which are public zone like Constitutional Square. We have a very long stretch of non-motorized areas, so we are going to put them in such places. And of course, where they are located in public places, the public will be mandated to pay not exceeding 200 shillings.
FIDA Uganda is calling on the National Identification Registration Authority to allow victims of war be provided with national identity cards, even if they do not meet the set criteria. This is during a presentation on data and statistics collected on the formerly abducted women and children born in captivity in a Acholi sub-region by the Greater North Parliamentary Forum. The data presented shows that Acholi sub-region has 2,886 women who were abducted by LRA and have produced over 3,200 children, of which 1,738 were produced in the bush. The chief executive officer of the organization, Lilian Biarugaba Adriko, says many of these women were abducted when they were still adolescents, which makes it hard for them to provide some of the information required to possess a national identity card.
Quest to NIRA is to consider them as a special category of people, and in turn issue them the national identity cards without asking for too much information that they are not able to give. And we believe that once they have these national identity cards, then they are able to access other services like health services, education, and so on.
State Minister in charge of Northern Uganda, Kuichinyi Gray, says the matter has been discussed in cabinet before and they have decided to follow the guidelines that will be set by the Electoral Commission, by the Minister of Internal Affairs. Police has asked parents to be vigilant with their children during the rainy season to avoid accidents that come with it. This follows an incident in Kawala, Lubaga municipality, where a child suspected to be 5 years old died after she was swept away into a drainage by running water during a heavy downpour. Kampala Metropolitan spokesperson Patrick Onyango explains more.
And nobody knows her within that area. So took the body to Mulago City Mortuary for post-mortem as we continue with the investigations. If you know you have lost a girl which is aged between 4 to 5 years, please go to Mulago Mortuary and help us with identifying the body. We appeal to members of the public not to allow their children to play during rainy season or when it is raining. If it is raining, your children should be in-house and should not allow them to move anyhow if it has stopped raining, or even to go and play near the trenches where water can take them.
In other news, the Democratic Republic of Congo's lower house of parliament has voted to remove its speaker in the latest round of a bitter rivalry between President Felix Tshisekedi with his predecessor and coalition partner Joseph Kabila. The vote, which took place, was a show of strength by Tshisekedi's allies, who might have enough support to form a new majority in parliament and bring down the government, which is dominated by Kabila loyalists. The National Assembly voted by 281 to 200 to impeach Speaker Jeanine Mabunda, a close ally to Kabila, accusing her of conflictual and partisan leadership and not being transparent about her management of the body's finances. During a rowdy debate that lasted hours, Mabunda denied the accusations against her and apologized for any misunderstandings. Cheers, hugs and dancing broke out among politicians when it was clear the motion had passed. That was the news.
XFM News on point.